with 8051 microcontroller. So if you see seven segment display, so this is a seven segment display. So this seven segment display is mainly used to display the numbers from 0 to 9. So here this will be, so this is the basic it will be like a IC. So this is a basic diagram for the seven segment display. So here display Bhavani. Common anode or common cathode, I will tell you. Okay, so so if it is a common cathode, you can make this a G bit as a 1. Okay, so the G bit as 1, remaining all are 0 means this will become 0. Okay, so this DP is for if you want to display some like that. So after ready, this is a EDH interface to the microcontroller. There is also a decimal point. Okay, there will be an also decimal point digits. Suppose you want to display 5.1, etc. So this decimal point can be used. Okay. So where we'll use this seven segment display? So these can be used in like why do you in order to display from the digits 8 to 9? By using this, we can display the characters from A to F also. Okay, so these are seven segments you are getting. If you see, so zero, suppose if you want to display zero, so what you need to do, so here G, you can make depending on common anode, common cathode, you can make G as 0 or 1. Suppose if you want to, so remaining, suppose if it is common cathode, remaining all A, B, C, D, E, F, these segments, these are nothing but, each segment is nothing but one LED. So remaining segments you can if it is a common cathode. Here B and C you can make one, and remaining so there is one is common cathode. Okay, common cathode means what? Cathode of all LEDs are connected, tied together, and it is connected to ground. And in order to glow the LED, what you need to do? You need to one second. Presenting. Okay. So so in order to glow the LED, what you need to do? You need to connect with logic high, that is 5 volts. Okay, anodes of these all LEDs are connected to logic high, so that is 5 volts. Suppose if it is a common anode, so common anode means what? All the anodes of this LED is connected to supply voltage, that is VCC, 5 volts. Okay, so 5 volts. So in order to glow this A to G, you need to give logic low. Okay, that is nothing but common anode. So common cathode means you need to give it to logic high, and common anode means you need to give it to the logic low. Okay, that is ground in order to glow the LEDs. Okay, so next if you see. This is a common anode. Suppose if you want to display zero, okay. So zero means what? Common anode. So if you see the common anode, except G, remaining you need to give it to zero. Okay, see here. Except G, A, B, C, D, E, F, you need to give it zero. And H is nothing but this decimal point. Decimal point also no need to glow this one. This LED, so that's why I'm making this H as one. Okay, I need to make H as one and G as one. I will get zero digit. Okay, so that if you convert into hexadecimal, 1100000, that is nothing but you are getting 0xC0, 0xC0. Okay, so suppose if you want to display a one. Okay, so one means except B and C. So B and C you need to give zero. Remaining all, no need to glow remaining all in common anode. Okay, so you need to give these as ones. Okay, and also this H also one. If you convert into hexadecimal, you are getting 0xF9. Okay, so like this, you can glow, you can give the values to the segment. Okay, so if it is a common cathode, if you see the common cathode, so when it is one, the specified LEDs will glow. So see here, when you want to display zero, so what you need to do, so no need to display this decimal, so you need to give common cathode means zero, and G also no need to display zero. Remaining A, B, C, D, E, F need to give it to one. Okay, so if you convert into hexadecimal, 0011 and 1111, so that is nothing but 3F. Suppose if you want to display like one, okay, so one means what? B and C need to give to one, and remaining all are zeros. Okay, so if you convert into hexadecimal, you are getting 0x06. Okay, so like this you can program. Okay, so now is any doubts in this concept? Students, give the response. Anyone, you can give response so that I can move forward. Sairam, anyone?
Sir.
Yeah, do you have any doubt in this 7 segment display?
No, sir.
Okay, so I will move forward. So here you need to execute the program in Keel software. So for that, we'll open the Keel software, and whatever the Keel software, I will explain you the program. After that, you have to generate the X-file. Again, you need to design the circuit in the Protuse software. So in the Protuse software, you should load the X-file into that microcontroller. Then if you run, our 7 segment display will work. Okay, so that I will show you. So this is the assembly language program. Okay, okay, so if you see this one, so this is a program. So first of all, what you need to do, you need to initialize one address, that is ORG 500H. okay, so define byte. So that is common cathode means, as I told you, you know, so common cathode means So whatever you need to glow, you need to give as 1. Okay. So DB 0x3FE is nothing but you need to display 0, 06, 1, 5B, 2, 4F, 3, and 66, 4, like that. Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these you have to initialize in the 500 location. That means in the 500 location, you have 3F. In 501, you have 06. 502, you have 5B. 503, 4F, like that. Okay. So up to so on, 507. Okay. 507, you have 67F. Okay. So this you need to initialize. After that, so ORG00H, this is the initial address. Okay. So next, so if you see this one, so ORG00H, move A comma as 00H. That means you have to initialize A with, so you have to clear the accumulator. And how many values you need to send? Total 10 values. So 10 values, so total 10 values are there. That means 50A up to 50A, these values will be stored. Okay. So that count you need to initialize. So here move R5 comma as 10. Okay. So as 10 is nothing but it's a decimal value. You are initializing with R5. So this is a counter. Data pointer, you are initializing. Data pointer is a 16-bit register. So in order to access external code memory, you are using the data pointer. So move DPTR comma as 500H. Okay. So you have to access the content in this address location. So first, what is that? What is first address? 3F is there. Okay. So 3F means move at the rate A plus DPTR. So that means 00 plus 500. So whatever the value present in the 500, what is the value present in the 500? 3F is there. So 3F, you are moving into which register? Accumulator. After moving this one into accumulator, so again, you need to move that whatever the value present in the accumulator into port 3. Okay. So that means 0 will be displayed in the 7 segment display. So you have to give some time to the that segment to display. Okay. So for that you need to call a delay, long call delay. So when you are calling this subroutine, what happens? It will come here. Okay. It will come here. So this is some small delay function you written. Move R0 comma as 07. Move R1 with 255. Move auto with 255 and decrementing and jump not equal to 0. So 255 times it will be in the same loop. Again, decrement jump not equal to R1 here too. Again, it will be. So that means you are introducing some delay over here. Okay. So after completing this, there is a return instruction. So here you are return instruction is there, means it will come to the main program. Now increment DPTR. So increment DPTR means now what is the initial value of DPTR? 500 is there. So it becomes 501. Increment DPTR means it becomes 501. And initializing the accumulator with 00. So next you need to decrement the count. So what is the count? 00. So that is 00. 10. 10 means it becomes 9. And checking for the condition either it is 0 or not. It is not equal to 0. Again, where it will jump? Here. Okay. Again, whatever the value present in 501 is there. So that is 06 is there, that you are moving into A register. So that means 0 plus 501. So in 501, you have 06. So 06, you are moving into A and you are moving into port 3. Again, you are calling a delay function and incrementing 502 becomes 502, increment DPTR and initializing the accumulator. Again, decrementing the count means count becomes 8. Okay. So like that, till the count becomes 8, whatever the values are there, that will be moved to accumulator. And from the accumulator, you are moving it to. How to execute this program. First, build the target. So build the target. So you are getting 0 errors. Warnings are nothing but no need to worry about that. Okay. So rebuild the target. Go to debug session. Start debug session. So here what you need to do, go to peripherals, IO port, in port 3 I want this, whatever the values, okay, and next so next go to memory. Here memory is there, memory window. So okay, so here the values will be available, 3f. So whatever the values I saved in this 500h location, 3f 06 5b 4f 66 6d 7d 07 7f 67, these are all are there. This will be stored in the location from 500 to 5e. Okay, 10 values are stored. Okay, 0 to 9. So step by step I am seeing. So I am executing this program. See here, first step by step. With what? So in the 500 location, what value is there? 3F is there. 3F, you are moving into accumulator. So see here, in accumulator you got 0x3f. Okay, so after that what you need to do, calling a delay function. Okay, so the delay will be executed. Okay, so this delay will be executed. So 256 times this delay will be executed. Okay. So after that, what happens after completing this delay, again 501 will be there. So in 501, what value is there? 06 is there. That value, it will be coming into the accumulator. Again, from the accumulator, it will come to the port. So see here. So in the port, you have what value? 3F here. This is 3F. 3F you got into port. So I will run this program here. Here, these values are coming into the port. These values are coming into the port. Okay, the delay is more. That's why I can't unable to see the step by step. So that's why if I am running the program, so these so see here, what you need to do, the students, do you understood the program? Okay, told. See this one, this is a Proteus software, Proteus. When the Proteus, I can do the simulation. So in this you can select this device and select 8089. One second, I will delete this and I will explain you. select the devices, pick up the devices, and select the microcontroller 8089C51. Okay, so 8089C51, here I have 8089C51. So select that microcontroller and place here. Okay, so you place here, and next I can zoom this one. And next, select the 7-segment common cathode. 7-segment common cathode display. Okay, so this is a 7-segment GMPX1CC. This is a red color common cathode. You can select and you can place over here. Here I am placing. And next, select the ground. Why? Because you have a DP, that is a decimal point that is connected to ground. That should be connected to ground. So here I am placing the decimal ground. Okay. So here, so this is decimal ground. Again, as I told you, these all lines are connected to ports. So here I am connecting to the ports. So here I am connecting. These are the wires I am connecting to this 7-segment display. Here I connected. Okay, so next what you need to do, I written the program. Okay, so this program I written, so for that I think you know how to generate the hex file. Go to target options for the target. Okay, so in that you need to select the clock frequency and the output. In the output you need to check the create hex file. Okay, so hex file already created, so that you want, so I already created. So next what you need to do, you need to select this one. Okay, so in this you need to select the clock frequency 11.0592 megahertz. This is the clock frequency. Okay, and next select the folder, and you need to select the hex file. Okay, so in the objects the hex file is there, 7-segment dot hex file is there, that you need to load into this hex file. Click OK and press play button. You got the output. That means it is glowing from, it's starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Again, it is coming to 0. Again, it is coming to 0. So like this, you need to know about the theory, the concept of what is a 7 segment. Those are two types, like what is 7 segment and what are the pins in that, and how to glow that 7 segment display. There are two types, like how many types are there, common anode and common cathode. So which signal we have to give to glow the particular LEDs to get the particular character or a number. And next we need to know about the programming. So after program, after getting the programming, you should generate the X file, and you have to design the circuit with the controller, 7 segment, and the connecting wires and ground. Okay, whatever the decimal point is there, that you need to connect to the ground. And so whatever the X file you generated in the Keel software, you need to load into that microcontroller. And if you press the play button here, the play button is there. In this downside, there is a play button. Okay, so downside there will be a play button. So if you play this button, that will run, and you can stop this. You can stop again. You can run the play button. Okay, so it will start blinking from 0 to 9. Okay, so like this, you can do the programming.